Okay. So this this will be a great spot to put up my tent and my gear. There's a little bit of trees around that gives protection from wind, but I have perfect view in 360 degree. And now we are at bortle 1. So the SQM value here are 22.00. Could not be any better. The sun is on the way down, so I will begin to dig a spot for my tent and put it up, and then put up my gear and wait for the stars to show up. I'm about to pack my gear. The forecast looks great for tomorrow. It will be clear the whole night between Saturday and Sunday. So I will go out west of town, 50-60 kilometers close to the mountains, where we have bortle 1 night skies. So I will bring some stuff. So first of all, my tent. I also have a warm sleeping bag, down sleeping bag that could handle minus 35 degree, and my warmest down jacket. I don't think it will be so cold tomorrow, maybe 15-16 degree, but it's always nice to have something warm to bring on. Gloves. Both these and my warmest thumb gloves, a hat, warm socks in wool, headlight, power bank, knife and axe, and my MSR stove, some food. A lamp and some fuel. So I feel a little bit excited actually. Today is a lovely day. It's quite warm. It's minus 9 degrees Celsius. The sun is up and shining. A little bit of cloud here close to Jokkmokk, but according to the forecast it will be a clear sky from about 6 p.m. and the whole night. So I'm about to drive west of town, 60 kilometers closer to the mountain range, where we have bortle 1 night skies. So I feel a little bit excited actually. This night could be one of the best this season. Quite warm, clear sky, bortle 1, and extremely beautiful out in the nature now. I also feel a little bit overwhelmed by all your comments and likes. There's quite a lot of work to do these videos, and without your likes and comments it would have been a lot more tough. So that feels great. And it's pretty exciting to know that people all over the world watching my trips and follow me out on the trips in these remote areas in Swedish Lapland. Getting closer now. I'm in the Pearl River Mountain Forest Reserve. There's a lot of snow in the terrain here. And the sun is shining on the mountain Jarre. Beautiful mountain, about 1,000 meter high. And it's actually warmer here than in Jokkmokk. It's only minus 6.5 degree. So it's it feels very promising for tonight. Probably the temperature will drop a couple of degrees during the night, but it will not be 30 degrees this night, I hope. Here we have my home for tonight. It's a Hilleberg Terra tent. Very sturdy mountain tent. And back there, there, you have the mountain Jarre. You can see around here, it's pretty nice. And as you can see, doesn't look that bad. So now I will dig a little bit more the spot for my mount and begin to prepare the gear. So now I have put up my gear. I will connect the ASIR Pro and the guide scope and the cables soon. And now then just to wait for the first stars to show up. I can see some stars already. So probably I will see the Polaris soon, and then I will do a polar alignment and wait until it's completely dark. So I will begin to do a polar alignment soon. I have not yet decided which object I will try to catch. Maybe the integrated flux nebulosity around M81 and M82, or maybe the Iris Nebula. I have put on my warm down jacket. It's, I don't know, maybe 10-15 degrees, so it's quite okay, actually, and completely clear sky, and begin to see a lot of stars now, but as you can see behind me, it's not really dark yet. You can take a look at my tent. Quite cozy, and I have my sleeping bag inside this. I have decided that I will do the Iris Nebula. It's a very beautiful little reflection nebula, which is surrounded also by dark nebulosity, dark clouds. So the challenge will be to try to catch these dark clouds. I have no idea how much time I need. So I will try to get 5, 6, 7, 8 hours tonight. But it depends on the clouds. But according to the forecast, it should be clear. Welcome into my tent. It has been a little colder now, so I think it's around minus 20 degrees outside the tent. I have this lamp. It gives a little bit of warmth inside the tent, so it's not that bad. I also have this cooling bag for food, but I have a warm water bottle in it to keep my tablet warm. And outside the tent, the starry sky is so great. I stood there for 15-20 minutes and just watched all these stars and the Milky Way, and saw the Andromeda Galaxy. So now we have company again by our green friend, the Aurora Borealis. And now I boil water, both to drink, but I also put hot water in this bottle and put it in my cooling bag where I have my tablet, so I can keep that warm. It's all quiet here. I heard a dog barking far away. But other than that, it's completely quiet, and the starry sky is majestic. Not now when I have my headlight on, but when I turn it off and leave my eyes to adapt for 5-10 minutes, I can see so many stars and objects. So it's a great night. and I was a little bit lucky that it's Saturday also, so I can spend the night out there, me and the stars in my tent. So I'm doing the Iris Nebula. I have taken about 20 exposures so far, 300 seconds. I think I will try to collect quite a lot of time on it, because it has these dark clouds around. So we'll see. It has been a little bit colder. Oh, yeah. sink down in the snow here. Yeah, it's probably 15-20 degree. In the sleeping bag here, and follow the photography on my tablet. So the guiding goes a little bit up and down right now, but it's okay, I think. I heard some noise, or not really noise, but I heard something walking around in the woods here. It could be a moose or reindeer, probably. Not a human. Okay, it's 11 p.m. and I had to take a break in my photography. There came some clouds and there were some aurora too that disturbed too much my shooting. I think I have done probably a little bit more than 3 hours, but I can't use all subs, especially the last ones were pretty bad. And for now it does not look that promising, but we'll see. Maybe this is temporary and it will clear later. But it also has been pretty cold. It's below minus 20 degrees Celsius for sure, maybe minus 25. So I think I will crawl into my warm mountain equipment sleeping bag, which has a comfort temperature of minus 35 degrees. So I will be fine in the sleeping bag. So we'll see if I can start to shoot again. My face to the sea, my back's to the land. And if you cannot come with me, I'll understand. Can we meet at the door? We don't have to say. Cause when you try